It's happy Monday, everyone. Welcome. Today we're going to be talking about pressure on set. It's coming. Whether you're in the US and it's a strike right now, when the industry comes back, there's going to be a lot of projects. There's going to be a lot of delay to catch up on. There's going to be more pressure than usual. And if you're in Europe or in other countries and you're not in strike right now, well, you're on set and you know there is pressure, right? So the type of pressure that I hear a lot of actors complain about is maybe the lack of time or the excess scenes that you have to do in poor time. You may have a lot of disagreements on set, a lot of different egos. You may have the director giving you one direction and then the DP giving you another one. You may have some struggles with some actors that you're playing with. You may be having some stuff with costume that is like itching you. You may be having issues with props. I mean, the list of things that can go not your way on set is endless. But basically, yes, a lot of people, so a lot of different opinions. Therefore, not everyone is working there for you. And there might be things that may come or may feel like they're coming in your way or preventing you from doing your job. And then time, right? Whether you're in a self-tape situation, actually, in an audition, or whether you're on set, there's usually not more time than what we would want, but less. And so there's pressure to do it quick, fast. And when it's your take, we only have one take, and that kind of situation. So you may feel that pressure is one of the reasons why you're not able to be at your best. And so you may have caught yourself really wishing it had happened differently because you were so ready and so prepared. And then you went on set and there was so much pressure that you couldn't be 100% and you didn't like the experience and you didn't like your performance. So the result didn't come out like you thought it would, right? So that happens. And you may have tried in the past to become better, to improve, to take another class, to just become stronger as an actor, or to be less sensitive to the pressure as an actor. So you may have tried the traditional route of, well, if I'm affected by this pressure, it means I'm not good enough for the pressure, and therefore I should get better, I should improve because I'm not enough. And so you're in a loop, because obviously no matter how many times you go to acting school or acting class, when you get on set and when there's pressure, it's never gonna come at you the way that you expect it to. It's never gonna be two sets are the same. So the pressure is always gonna surprise you, and you wanna make sure that you're ready to deal with it, right? Because pressure on set is absolutely normal. So it's not about everyone on set needs to become better so that you can have a nice time acting. That's never going to happen. There's too many people, too much money involved, too little time for it to be a very flowy experience. Or at least that's very rare when it does happen. So you have to start coming from the perspective that the pressure is completely to be expected. It's part of the package. It's part of acting. You will have pressure on set. So are you ready for it? Are you able to show up on set and just flow with what's coming? There's going to be surprises, people, time, things, stuff, technicalities, egos, conflicts, a lot of things. Can you actually start being with that? Because you can't build a shield against it. There's nothing that you can do to become stronger than the pressure. That's not the idea, because then you would close yourself. You would have to shield yourself and you wouldn't be present anymore. So the more confident you're going to try to stay on set, the more untouchable you're going to try to be on set, the less open you're going to be, the less present you're going to be, the less available you're going to be. So that won't work. You'll have to put a mask of, no, I'm fine. Everything's okay. I can do this. I'm confident. I'm fine. I'm strong. But that's not what gets you to the truth of who you are, to the juice of your instrument, and to the art that you want to create, right? So it's really about, in the work that we do, making sure, first of all, that you are able to be with any types of sensations inside of your body. So in the work that we do in the reset journey, And by the way, I have to announce that very soon we're going to do a live reset, which we haven't done in 4 years. So stay tuned, ask us, send us some DMs if you want some more information about that. You can also sign up on our newsletter list on our website, tobeornottoact.com. Mid-October we're starting, so if you want to be part of a live reset, that's like I said, the last time it happened was 4 or 5 years ago, so it's very exceptional. And since we need a lot of togetherness right now, that's what we're going to do. But yeah, the work that we do in the reset is to really make sure that you are comfortable to be with any sensation that's happening inside of you at all times. So we make sure that you're not stuck in learned behaviors of, oh, I should be like this, or I have to feel like that, or I shouldn't feel afraid, or I can't feel like this. So we're moving through all of that in the reset, all your conditioning, all of your learned behaviors, so you can just comfortably be with your sensations, with your emotions, whether they are sensations that are comfortable or uncomfortable. So you can have some happy emotions, some joy, you can have some sadness, some rage. We help you remember what it's like to actually feel that in your body. When you're able to be with yourself, with everything that's happening inside of you, and not to deny it, not to neglect it, not to cut out of it, not to disembody, not to numb, but to actually feel it and let that energy move. When that is done and you're reset and capable to be fully alive, like you were when you were a child, where you would just feel something and go with it, or feel something inside and need to say it and you say it. So you're flowing, you're pure, you're completely alive, not repressing or resisting anything. Then when you're on set and there's pressure, what you do is that the pressure feeds you, because you're open to it, and in character, it informs you, it gives you energy. No matter what kind of pressure you have, it will serve you. So again, instead of finding ways to deal with pressure or to push it away or to be stronger than it, all of those would be tricks that would actually not enable you to be present. What we do in this work is we help you to first work on your instrument, on everything that's happening inside of you, so you can remind yourself what it's like to be you again, what it's like to feel your feelings, to feel your sensations inside of your body, your emotions, inside of your energy. When that's done, then you're able to comfortably be with an environment that can be having pressure, and you're able to integrate that into your performance. You're able to use that. It feeds you energy. Right now, you're probably not able to deal with pressure. You're probably able to just push it away or try to get stronger or deny it. But when you're doing that, you're closing your instrument. So again, if this is interesting to you, let us know. We can send you some more information. And if you've been following me for a little while, you know that we don't do lives, but since these extraordinary times need extraordinary solutions and offers, we're wanting to tune into togetherness. I can't speak today. That's kind of obvious. We want to lean into togetherness and have a live reset. I'm going to do that mid-October. So if you're interested, you can sign up on our newsletter and I'll send you some information. All right. Thank you. Bye, guys.